فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
علي بن حجر رحمه الله, he died في أواخر شهر ذي الحجة, the first days of ذي الحجة, سنة 52 و800. He died the year 852 Hijriyah. That's when he died, rahimahullah ta'ala. Now is kalimatul hawla, hawla al-kitab. Now we're going to speak about the book. What is this book that we're studying? What is it about? What does it do? Who explained this book? A bit about the book, inshallah. First of all, let's explain what the book is. What's it called? It's called Nukhbatul Fikr. Fi mustalah ahli al-athar. That's the name of the book. It's called Nukhbatul Fikr. Fi mustalah ahli al-athar. What does that mean? Nukhba, what does that mean, first of all? Nukhba, what does it mean? In English, for word, it means elite. The word elite means chosen, right? Naam. Lughatan, the word in the Qamus, the word Nukhba means al-mukhtar, the person who's chosen, the elite, chosen one. Ikhtarahu, that which he chose. So if you go to the kitab book Al-Qamus Al-Muhit by Fayrouza Abadi, if you look at the madda of Nakhaba, you find that it's chosen. The second one is Fikr. What's Fikr? Fikr is jam'u Fikra. Fikr is plural. And the singular is Fikr. Fikra. Fikr is plural. Fikr. Fikra, just with a ta' marbuta at the end, Fikra. Is what? Singular. It's like the word nihla. Nihal is how you make it plural. Fikr here means what? I'malul khatiri fi shay. It's thought. It's to make, it's thought. Fikr means fikra, thought. Idea. It means to make your brain work. Come with an idea. إِعْمَالُ الْخَاطِرِ is to make your mind work في الشيء in a matter. Also the word فِكَر also means what? It also means التأمل, observation. By looking at something, observing it, and again it involves your mind working. But you're looking at it, you're observing it, you're analyzing it, and your mind is also working as well. What does it mean? It's called نُخْبَةُ الْفِكَر. في مصطلح أهل الأثر. في مصطلح أهل الأثر. What does the word مصطلح mean? This is all the time we came. إصطلاحا مصطلح. What does it mean? We hear it a lot. What the word مصطلح means? مصطلح means هو التوافق. It is an agreement على استعمال الفاظ. It is an agreement to use a word, مخصوصتي specifically, يتداولها أهل كل فن. Every field, the scholars of that field would say, we are going to use this word as this, and that's the definition amongst us. That's it, that's called istilah. What does it mean? العرف الخاص. It means amongst a people, this is what it means. That's what they agreed upon, that they're going to define it as. That means istilah. سواء التوافق على استعمال الفاظ مخصوصة يتداولها أهل كل فن على وجه التعارف فيما بينهم كما اصطلحوا عليها, which they agree upon. You and us, we're going to use this word, this is what it means, and this is how we're going to use it. That's called what? اصطلاحا. اصطلاح, that's what it means. لغة. What, like in the word مصطلح here means what? Now the word اصطلاح, we defined what it meant, we spoke about it. But what does the word مصطلح mean? مصطلح means it is معرفة, it is to know. القواعد المعرفة بحال الراوي والمروي. It is to know the principles that will allow you to know the situation of a narrator. One who's narrating. والمروي and the one that's been narrated from. The one that's narrating and the one that's been narrated from. Their situation. Observing it. Who are they? What are they? That's called مصطلح. So the word al-mustalah, when it's like mentioned like that, we understand it as what? Mustalah al-Hadith. The scholars of Hadith. That is the definition. Ahlul Athar. So the book is called Nukhbatul Fikr Fi Mustalah. We mentioned Mustalah. We mentioned Nukhba. We mentioned Fikr. Fi Mustalah, we mentioned Mustalah. Ahlul Athar, what does it mean? Ahlul Athar is going to come to us what it means in details. But Ahlul Athar is meant by Ahlul Hadith. The word Athar means Hadith. The people of the text. The people of what? Those who follow. The footstep. The word Athar means it's a footstep. It's footprints, sorry. Footprints. It is footprints. Those who are upon the footprints of those before them. They're treading over it. Athari. Ahlul Hadith. So his book is on that field. Nukhbatul Fikr fi Mustalah Ahli Al-Athar. This book, so we know now what it means, right? What does it deal with? That's the second question. Or what is it considered? يُعَدُّ هَذَا الْكِتَابِ This kitab is considered اختصاراً. It's considered as an abridged, summarized. لِتَصَانِيف فِي مُصْطَلَحِ أَهْلِ الْحَدِيثِ All the books that have been written in Hadith, of this field of science of Hadith, it's considered a summarized, abridged, in which he later will mention to us, inshallah, when we go into his book. Because the books that are written in it, كَثُرَتْ وَبُسِطَتْ وَاخْتُصِرَتْ This field of Hadith, the books that have been written, some of them are lengthy and they are explaining even more and they go to details and something like that. And there are a lot in number. And some of them, وَاخْتُصِرَتْ Some of them summarized it. They brought you what? They brought you the khulasa, the conclusion that you need to know as a person who's learning the science. He's giving you a summarized. And that's what his intent was. That was the intent of who? Him, rahimahullah ta'ala. Because later, inshallah, when we go into the kitab, he mentions in his explanation of his book, he calls it, look what he says, al-muhim min dhalik. My intent is to bring you the most important part of it. Also, he said, rahimahullah, fi awraqin latifatin in pages, which are beneficial, good pages, bring you the important points, not waste many, many, many pages. Good. He also said, مَعَ فَرَائِدَ ضُمَّتْ إِلَيْهِ وَفَوَائِدَ زِيدَتْ عَلَيْهِ But not to think that just because he summarized his book and that he brought it small. Sometimes what happens is when some people summarize, نُعْ مِنَ الْخَلَلْ falls into their books. They drop out things they shouldn't have not taken out. That's not what happened. He said, my book, even though it's summarized, even though it's abridged, all this is going to come to us later, him saying it. But he said, my one, I've added benefits to it. Points, that I've added to it that you may not even find in the big books. In the big books, some things you might not find in it, and it's true, you find something in it. This book, so that's what his intent was. It's a summarized, اختصار للتصانيف اصطلاح أهل الحديث. We mentioned that. And that was his intent. The scholars, they praised it. And inshallah we'll see examples of how they praised it. They praised it. Some scholars, when they praised it, they said, وَالنَّجْمُ تَسْتَصْغِرُ الْأَبْصَارُ صُورَتَهُ وَالذَّنْبُ لِلطَّرْفِ لَا لِلنَّجْمِ فِي الصِّغَرِ وَالنَّجْمُ the stars تَسْتَصْغِرُ The stars, what do they become? They become little in the eyes. صُورَتَهُ Its image. The stars, great. But they're good. But they become small in the eyes of the people. Isn't that the case? Because of the existence of the moon and the stars and stuff, the sun, they become nothing. Not that the stars is nothing, but look at that. Meaning the Hajar's works. Even though the scholars have written good. MashaAllah, what they've said is good. But like in this is like, kitab which is beneficial like that. Some scholars, they went on to the point where they said, عِلْمُ الْحَدِيثِ غَدًا فِي نُخْبَةِ الْفِكَرِ The عِلْمُ الْحَدِيثِ, the science of hadith, Tomorrow, if you want to look for it, tomorrow, it's in Nukhbatul Fikr. Naran ala alamin yad'u ulul athari. It's like a fire ala alamin from a knowledgeable scholar of ilm yad'u ulul athari. calling the people of text and evidences. And because of that, brothers, because of that praise and because of that beauty and the way it's written, ulama have given it consideration. اهتمّ العلماء. Scholars have given a lot of consideration to it. والطلاب, and students of knowledge. حفظاً, they start to memorize it. ودراسةً, and to teach it. وتعليماً, and to study it, and to teach it. وشرحاً, ونظماً, وتحشيةً. They put explanations on it. They even made it poetries. They even put footnotes scholars have not left it. And we're going to mention all of that. فممن شرحها, from the scholars who put شرح on it. Ha. Who put شرح on it, is first of all deserving to mention, is himself. He explained his own book. He called it نزهة النظر في توضيح نخبة الفكر في مصطلح أهل الأثر. That's all one name. He did it. The second is كمالالدين الشمني. كمالالدين الشمني. He called it نتيجة النظر. And he's the man who's going to refute later. In which he refutes, and who tried to explain the book why Ibn Hajar was alive. And then he refutes him on the explanation. Also, Abu al-Fadl, Ahmed ibn Sadaqat al-Qahiri. He explained it, he called it عنوان معاني نخبة الفكر. Ibn Musa al-Marakishi. He explained it, he called it شرح نخبة الفكر. Muhammad Abdul Ra'uf al-Munawi. He done a sharh on it, he called it نتيجة الفكر. And وله شرح آخر, and he has also another explanation on it, which is abridged. Muhammad Abdul Ra'uf al-Munawi. Six, Abdul Aziz ibn Abdul Salam al-Uthmani. He called it Istijla' al-Basar min sharh nukbat al-fikr. Also, Ibn Himmat al-Dimishqi. He has a sharh on it. Fi kitab which is called Natijat al-Nadar. And also, Ismail al-Haqqi. He explained it. Also, number nine, Muhammad Abdullahi al-Kharashi al-Maliki. He called it منتهى الرغبة في حل ألفاظ النخبة and other than them. The second point, which is those who made it poetry. Kamaluddin Muhammad ibn Muhammad al-Shumunni, he made it nazm, poetry. Shihabuddin al-Tufi, who is a student of Kamaluddin Muhammad ibn Muhammad al-Shumunni, Shihabuddin al-Tufi, he done a nazm of it, poetry. Burhanuddin, Muhammad ibn Ibrahim al-Maqdisi, he made a nazm of it. Also, Shihabuddin ibn Sadaqah, he made a nazm of it. Also, Radiyuddin al-Izzi, he done a nazm of it. Mansur al-Tablawi, he done a nazm of it. Also, Muhammad ibn Ismail al-Amir al-San'ani, he done a nazm of it, and he called it Qasabu al-Sukar, fi nazmi nukhbatu al-fikr. And that's very known, inshallah, we're going to take some lines of it, inshallah, whilst explaining the book, bi'idhni Allah with it. Abdullah ibn Umar al-Yamani, he also done a nazm of it. Kamaluddin al-Adhami, he done it, a nazm of it. Uthman ibn Sanad al-Baqari, he done a nazm of it. So ulama brothers, they came, they made sharah of it, they made nazm of it. And the reason why I'm saying all of these names is to show you that all these people will not waste their time on something that's not worth being explained. Or that's not worth to put made into a poetry. Sanani, rahimahullah, which is the Qasab al-Sukar, when he came to Nukhbat al-Fikr, look at the praise he put to it. It deserves to be mentioned. The great scholar, Sanani, rahimahullah. The author of the kitab, Subul al-Salam, which is the Sharh al-Bulugh al-Maram, the Yemeni scholar, he said, وَبَعْدُ فَالنُّخْبَةُ فِي عِلْمِ الْأَثَرُ مُخْتَصَرٌ يَحَبَّذَا مِنْ مُخْتَصَرُ أَلَّفَهَا الْحَافِظُ فِي حَالِ السَّفَرُ أَلَّفَهَا الْحَافِظُ فِي حَالِ السَّفَرُ وَهُوَ الشِّهَابُ بْنُ عَلِيِّ بْنُ حَجَرُ طَالَعْتُهَا يَوْمًا مِنَ الْأَيَّامِ فَاشْتَقْتُ أَنْ أُودِعَهَا نِظَامِ فتم من بكرة ذاك اليوم إلى المساء عند وفود النوم مشتملا على الذي حواه فالحمد للرحمن لا سواه. This book Ibn Hajar, by the way, he wrote it whilst he was a traveler. he was traveling. This kitab Nukhbatul Fikr as Sanaani mentions. Allafah al-Hafidh. Hafidh explained it. Fi hal al-safar. He authored it in a journey. He was traveling. Ibn Hajar rahimahullah ta'ala. So Sakhawi mentions the year he finished his book. I mean, the way year he finished writing it. He finished the year, rahimahullah, sanat athnatay ashara wa thamani mi'a, 812. And the first ever time that the Nukhbatul Fikr was published, inna ula tab'at al-Nukhba, this Nukhba, the first publication that came out that we're aware of, فِيمَا نَعْلَمْ, that which we know, it was in India, came out in India. They published it in India, the year 1272. And there's, where did they do it? In Matba'atul Jamarili. Matba'ah, a publication called Al-Jamarili. They were the one who published it. Naam. The author, rahimahullah, Ibn Hajar, he said, Alhamdulillahi alladhi lam yazal aliman qadiran. That's where the book starts from. The Bismillah is in your copies. Does it say Bismillah at the top? Laysa min al-mu'allif. It's not from the mu'allif. Bismillah is not by the mu'allif. It's the muhaqqiq of the kitab who put his tahqiq on it. The author, he started his book from the hamdalah. Alhamdulillah, he praises to Allah. Alladhi lam yazal aliman qadiran. The praises to Allah, the one who has not remained except aliman, one who has knowledge. Qadiran, one that has the ability. So the Shaykh rahimahullah, he started his book bilhamdalah. He started his book with alhamdulillah. And the reason why he did is because he followed the hadith Abu Dawood and Ibn Majah and Ibn Hibban and Ahmed ibn Hanbal narrated. That the messenger said, كُلُّ أَمْرٍ ذِي بَالٍ لَا يُبْدَأْ فِيهِ بِحَمْدِ اللَّهِ فَوَقْطَعْ. Any matter in which a person starts and does not start with Alhamdulillah, for verily that matter is disconnected. That matter is insufficient. That matter is incomplete. That the Prophet said this. This hadith, Imam al-Nawawi, he considered it to be hasan, sound. In his Al-Adhkar. And others have weakened it. Alhamdu. As Imam ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah, he mentioned in his kitab, Al-Wabil al-Sayyib. That Alhamdu, it means what? هو الإخبار عن الله. It is to inform about Allah. بصفات كماله. مع محبتي والرضا به. Ibn al-Qayyim says, it means is to inform about Allah. With his complete characteristics, with love, and it's to be pleased with him, tabarak wa ta'ala. It's to be pleased with him. To love him, al-ridha bihi. Al-thana, the word al-thana, is huwa takrir, it is the hamd, repeating shay'an ba'da shay. If you keep praising Allah, alhamdulillah, it becomes thala. Praise. There is a difference between hamd and thala. They both are praise in English, but in Arabic there's a difference. Hamd, thala is when you say it many times. It's when you say it many times. Ibn al-Qayyim mentions both of those in his kitab Al-Wabil al-Sayyib. Ibn al-Qayyim says that. The word alhamdu, the alif al-lam in it. It is lil jins. Ay jinsul hamdi. The hamd in and within itself. Aw in istighraq, or it can mean all of hamd is for Allah. All of it. The word istighraq in the Arabic language, it is anything you can put the word kul in its position. So the word kul, all. Kul, all. So alhamdu means all of praises to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Or it can mean The hamd in and within itself is for Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala.